6 o'clock silence of a new day beginning is heard in the small Texas town. Like a signal from nowhere, the people who live there are up and moving around. 'Cause there's bacon to fry, there's biscuits to bake on the stove that the Salvation Army won't take. You open the windows and you turn on the fan, 'cause it's hotter than hell when the sun hits the land. Walter and Fanny, will they own the grocery that sells most all that you need? They've been up and working since early this morning. They've got the whole village to feed. They put out fresh eggs, throw bad ones away that rotted because of the heat yesterday. The store is all dark so you can't see the flies that settle on round steak and last Monday's pies. Sleepy Hill's drugstore and the cafe are open. The coffee is bubbling hot, 'cause the folks that ain't working gonna sit there till sundown and talk about what they ain't got. Someone just blew a clutch in the old pickup truck. Seems like they're riding on a streak of bad luck. The doctor bills came and the well has gone dry. Seems their grown kids don't care whether they live or die. Hell, I can remember when Cockrell, Texas was a good place for a man to live and raise a family. Of course, that's before the cotton gin closed down. It's been that long ago. You know, it seems like only yesterday old Steve Hughes lost his arm in that infernal machine and walked all the way home bleeding to death. Of course, new highway helped some when they dammed up to Brazos to build Lake Whitney. Brought some fishermen down from Dallas to Fort Worth. Town sure has been quiet, though, since they closed down the depot and built that new trestle out west of town. You know, the train just don't stop here anymore. No, the train just don't stop here anymore. Well, the last time I remember that train stopping at the depot was when me and my Invita came a-riding back from Waco. I remember I was wearing my long pants and we was sharing conversation with a man who sold ballpoint pens and paper. And the train stopped once in Clifton, where my aunt bought me some ice cream and my mom was there to meet us when the train pulled into Cockrell. Now kids at night break when the lights and the sound of trains only remains in the memory of the ones like me who have turned their backs on the splintered tracks in the walls that stand on the railroad land where we used to play and then run away from the depot man. Yeah, but the train just don't stop here anymore. Well, I remember me and brother used to run down to the depot just to listen to the whistle when the train pulled into Cockrell. And the engine, big and shiny, black as coal, it fed the fire. And the engineer, he'd smile and say, howdy, how you fellas? And the people by the windows playing cards and reading papers looked as far away to us as next summer's school vacation. But now kids at night break when the lights and sound of trains only remains in the memory of the ones like me who have turned their backs on the splintered tracks and the walls that stand on the railroad land where we used to play and then run away from the depot man. Wonder why it is you never see no young folks around Cockrell. Seems like as soon as the last part of May rolls around, all the seniors graduate. Well, they go running off to Cleburne to Fort Worth, get them a good job. Mary Martin was a schoolgirl, just 17 or so, when she married Billy Archer about 14 years ago. Not even out of high school, folks said it wouldn't last. But when you grow up in the country, you grow up mighty fast. They married in a hurry, in March before school was out. Folks said that she was pregnant, just wait and you'll find out. It came about that winter, one gray November morn. First of many more to come, a baby boy was born. And cattle is their game, and Archer is the name they give to the acre that they own. If the Brazos don't run dry and the newborn calves don't die, another year from Mary will have flown. Another year from Mary will have flown. Now Billy, he kept what cattle his daddy could afford, bouncing across the cactus in a 1954. But the cows was sick and skinny, and the weeds was all that grew. But Billy kept the place alive, the only thing he knew. And Mary cooked the supper, and Mary scrubbed the floors. And Mary busted horses and blew the baby's nose. And Mary and a shotgun kept the rattlesnakes away. But how she kept on smiling, no one could ever say. And cattle is their game, and Archer is the name they give to the acre that they own. If the Brazos don't run dry and the newborn calves don't die, another year from Mary will have flown. Another year from Mary. Now the drought of 57 was a curse upon the land. No one in Bosque County could give Bill a helping hand. The ground was cracked and broken, and the truck was out of gas. And cows can't feed on prickly pear instead of growing grass. Well, the weather got the water, and a snake bite took a child. And a fire in the old barn took the hay that Bill had piled. The mortgage got the money, and the screwworm got the cows. The years have come for Mary, she's a-waiting for him now. And cattle is their game, and Archer is the name they give to the acres that they own. If the Brazos don't run dry and the newborn calves don't die, another year from Mary will have flown. Another year from Mary will have flown. Six o'clock silence of a new day beginning is heard in the small Texas town. Like a signal from nowhere, the people who live there are up and moving around. 'Cause there's bacon to fry and there's biscuits to bake on the stove that the Salvation Army won't take. And you open the windows and you turn on the fan, 'cause it's hotter than hell when the sun hits the land.